What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the ExcellentCrates Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Obtaining items is a staple part of the Minecraft game, and to make this even better, some server owners add systems for players to gain items in other ways than finding them naturally. Whether they are used for survival, decoration, or other crafting materials, you need a lot of items to make it through your world, and the plugin ExcellentCrates is a great way to get them. Visit the ExcellentCrates spigot page and press the blue Download Now button in the top right. After doing that, save the jar file to a safe location, and then head to the Next Engine plugin's GitHub. Click the Next Engine jar file and then save it to your computer. Head to your Apex server panel, stop the server, and then make sure you're running a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot. After that, enter the FTP file access on the left-hand side, log in, and then find or create the plugins folder and enter it. Press upload in the top left, and on the next page, drag and drop the jar files into the upload area. Once they're 100% done, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. Once you're ready, start by using the /crate editor command from in-game. This will open a GUI menu, allowing you to click the chest item to manage crates. Afterwards, press the green block to create a new one. You will then be prompted to enter a unique crate identifier, which is its ID. Enter any name you want into the chat bar, and once that's entered, your new crate will now be available within the GUI menu. From the crates manager, select your specific crate to open the editor menu. This will have a large amount of options to modify, and it's useful for adding animations, the rewards, and other aesthetics. Some additional options will also be available, but they will require extra plugins like holographic displays and citizens. Here is a full list of the available settings that you're able to change in this menu. You can pause the video now if you want to get a closer look at each option. Now, before you can place your crate down, you have to add some rewards. To do this, enter your crate options menu from earlier, press the emerald symbol, and then press new reward. Similar to before, you're going to be asked to enter an identifier for the reward. Now that that's done, you can open the rewards editor and access more options. In addition to programming rewards, it's also recommended to program some crate keys. Once this is added, it means that you can only open the crate once you have the correct key. To get started, go to the crate editor menu, but enter the key manager instead. Just like before, create a new key and then enter an ID for it, and then if you want to, adjust the key's options to change the name, item, and whether or not the key is digital. With your key created, you can now add it to your crate for use. Enter the options menu for your crate and then click the keys option. From here, enter the ID for your key or select one of the suggested values in the chat. Now you can finally place the crate. It can be added to any block, whether it's a chest, lectern, or more. To start, place your desired crate block in your world, then enter the options menu. Click the chest icon and then right-click on the desired block. If none of the plugin commands are working, try to use the plugins command from in-game. If no plugins are listed, ExcellentCrates has not been installed. Return to the FTP file access and make sure both of the jar files have been uploaded into the plugins folder. It also could be that you don't have the correct permissions to use commands. To gain access to all of the commands, all you have to do is op your player in the server console, but for specific permissions, you can use a plugin like LuckPerms. Just like that, your new crate will be accessible to anyone that has a key. This is a great option to give players something to work towards or to have as a reward for server activities like voting. The options are entirely customizable, allowing players to open crates with currency or experience too. So I recommend creating a variety of crates with different purposes and rewards. That's all for this one, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.